Dear learners, welcome to you all in online class of Hazil Almiya City College. I am Sheikh Sora Hussain, your English teacher. Dear learners, this is the very first time I am taking a session with you, but in a very different way. Each year, we start class directly in our academic institute, that is in the classroom, but because of coronavirus pandemic 2019, the whole world is affected. In the same way, our country is also affected with this coronavirus pandemic. So this time we have to take our classes in a very different way, that is via online. Dear learners, you know you have two papers in English, first paper and second paper in SSC level, and both paper carries 100 marks. So in English, in SSC level, you have 200 marks. Dear learners, I think by this time you have collected your prescribed textbook and helping book that is mentioned in our prospectus. Dear learners, first of all, syllabus for first paper. In first paper, you have 100 marks. First, reading test, 60 marks. Question number 1, first scene comprehension, and there you have to make MCQ question 1 into 5, 5 marks. Then you have to answer 5 short question, 5 into 2, equal to 10 marks. Dear learners, this scene comprehension will be selected from your textbook EFT English for today for class 11 and 12. Then another scene comprehension, that is second scene comprehension, will be set from your textbook, and there you will be asked to make a flow chart, and this flow chart contains 10 marks. Then another scene comprehension, that is third scene comprehension, will be selected from your textbooks, and here in third scene comprehension you will be asked to make a summary, and this contains 10 marks. Dear learners, I have already given you question number 1, 2 and 3, that is first scene comprehension, second scene comprehension and third scene comprehension. All these three comprehension will be set up from your EFT, that is English for today. But this time here is question number 4, that is fill in the blanks with clues, 0.5 into 10 equal to 5 marks. That is, if each blanks contains half marks, and there will be 10 blanks, and at first you will be given a table, there you will get 10 words. From there you are to fill half the blanks, and these text will be set up by the question setter. He may set up from the textbook directly, or he may summarize or develop himself from any element of the text, or he himself can make it from anywhere, or from his own self. Then question number 5, fill in the blank without clues. Here you will be given a text and there will be 10 blanks. Each blank will be marking like A, B, C, D, E, F and J. And you are to fill in these blank places with appropriate words. This time, and no clue is given for you. Okay, dear learners, this text will be also developed by the question setter. Then question number 6, rearrange from jumbled sentences. There will be 10 jumbled sentences and you are to rearrange this. And here marks 10. There will be 10 sentences, so 10 marks. Dear learners, in case of your answer, you will write the numbers in box. You need not to present the whole paragraph. Dear learners, this time writing test 40 marks in your first paper. Question number 7, question based paragraph 10 marks. Dear learners, you will be given some question, 5 to 7 question. Based on this question, you are to develop a single paragraph. Dear learners, you must write this paragraph in a single para. And here, don't forget to give a headline of the paragraph. And those question given in the question paper, only the hints how you will develop the paragraph. Then question number 8, story completing. This item contain 7 marks. Dear learners, here in question paper, you will be given the beginning of a story within a 2 or 3 or 4 sentences. Then you are to complete the story. Here you are to give a headline for the story at first. Then you are to write down the sentences mentioned in the question paper, that is the beginning of the story. Then you are to continue the story from there. Then question number 9, informal email or informal letter. This item carrying 5 marks. Dear learners, here remember in first paper you have to write informal email or informal letter, but in second paper there is also email, but that is formal. So remember, in first paper informal email or informal letter. Then question number 10, describing map, graph or chart. This item carrying 10 marks. Dear learners, in question paper you will be given either graph or chart, and you have to describe that in your own way. There will be some direction in the question paper and you have to follow that. Then theme writing from poem. This item carrying 8 marks, and here you have to write this theme within 50 words only, not more than that. You are not allowed to write the theme of the poem within 50 words only. Not, you will not write it more than 50 words. Dear learners, this poem may be set from your textbook. There are 11 poems in your textbook, or the teacher can set it from anywhere of English literature. You have to only write down here the theme. So you have to know how we can develop a theme. Dear learners, all these items, that is writing test, here in question paper there will be some guideline for you. That is word limit, maybe word limit here you have to write the paragraph within 150 words or 200 words. Then you have to complete the story within 150 words or 100 words, like this. So you have to then theme writing, in case of theme writing, you have to complete it within 50 words. Then describing, map, graph or chart here in question paper, there may be like this, that you have to develop or describe this graph of, or chart within 120 words. All these things you have to follow, as this writing test is known as guided writing. There will be some guidelines for you in question paper and you have to follow that. Okay, dear learners. Dear learners, now second paper, 100 marks. At first, grammatical items, that is grammar, 12 into 5, 60 marks. That is, there will be 12 grammatical items in second paper, each item carrying 5 marks, so 60 marks in grammar. Question number 1, article. Question number 2, suitable preposition. Question number 3, completing sentences with suitable phrases or words. Then completing sentences with clauses or phrases. Then question number 5, right form of verbs. Then question number 6, changing sentence. Dear learners, in case of article, a text will be developed by the question setter. There will be 10 blank spaces, and these blank spaces will be numbered by A, B, C, dot, dot, J. So, in your answer paper, you have to write only the number, that is A, B, C, and then the answer, that is the right article in right number. Then question number 2, in the same way, another text will be developed by the question setter, and there will be 10 blank space as usual, and there you have to write or use suitable preposition, that is the right preposition you have to place there. Then in case of question number 3, completing sentence with suitable phrases or words, there at least there will be 10 or more sentences, and each sentence will be marked A, B, C, dot, dot, J, and there will be a blanks at last. So in blank space you have to complete it, but here you will get a clue. At first, in question number 3, you will get a box. There will be 10 phrases or words, and from there you have to complete the right phrase or words in blank space. Then question number 4, again completing sentences with clauses and phrase. There is a difference between phrase and words. Here you have to complete with the help of word or phrase, but here you have to complete it either clause or either with phrase. In case of question number 3, here the answer may be only a single word, but in case of question number 4, here a number of words, that is phrase or a complete clause, will be the answer, not the single words. Okay, then right form of verbs. Here the developer or the question setter will develop a paragraph or text. There will be 10 blank spaces, and beside this blank space, that is in right portion or right hand of the blank space, there will be base form of verbs. Then you have to write the right form of verbs in the blank space. Then question number 6, changing sentence. Dear learners, this is a very big one. Here you have to learn voice sense, that is from active to passive or passive to active. Then you have to change here inter form of sentence, that is from assertive to interrogative or interrogative to assertive or affirmative to negative or negative to affirmative or then from assertive to exclamatory or then from exclamatory to assertive or here you have to change from simple to complex or compound or from complex to simple or compound or from compound to simple or complex. Then here you have to change the degrees also, that is from positive to comparative or superlative in the same way or vice versa from other degrees to other degrees. Okay. Dear learners, in grammatical item question number 7, narrative style. Dear learners, here you have to change from direct narration to indirect narration or from indirect narration to direct narration. Then question number 8, unclear pronoun reference. Here text will be developed by the question setter. There will be some mistake of pronoun or noun and you have to correct it. And here you have to answer the text in a full, and where you will change the pronoun or where you will change pronoun to noun or noun phrase, there you have to underline. Then question number 9, modifiers. Dear learners, you know pre-modifier and post-modifier. So there will be a text and there will be 10 blank spaces. There you have to write the modifier that is directed in the right portion of a blanks. According to the direction, you have to place the modifiers. Then question number 10, sentence connectors. Dear learners, a text will be developed by the question setter, and at the very beginning or end of the sentence there will be a blank space and you have to place there the right sentence connectors. And then question number 11, synonym and antonym. A text will be developed by the question setter, and from the text there will be you will be asked to write synonym of 5 words and you will asked to write of antonym of 5 words. Then question number 12, correcting punctuation. Here a text will be developed by the question setter. There will be 10 errors or missing of punctuation marks. You have to write in correct punctuation. Dear learners, now in second paper, composition writing 40 marks. And all this is called the freehand writing. And in case of this freehand writing, there will be some guideline in question paper in each question. And you have to follow that directive, maybe word limit or other things. Question number 3, formal letter or email. Marks carrying 8, dear learners, here you will be asked to write any application. Formal letter means application or formal email. Then question number 14, report writing, marks carrying 8. Here you will be asked to write a report on a particular topics to publish in newspaper. Then question number 15, style based paragraph. Style based paragraph, mark carrying 10. Dear learners, here you will be asked to write either narrative paragraph or cause and effect paragraph or comparison and contrast paragraph or listing paragraph. There are some style in writing paragraph, that is descriptive style, narrative style, persuasive style, cause and effect, comparison and contrast, listing, etc. From there your question will be from 4 particular style, that is narrative style or cause and effect style or from comparison and contrast style or from listing style. Then question number 16, short composition. Mark carrying 14 dear learners. Here you will be asked to write a short composition on a particular topics, and there will be given some word limit that may be from 200 to 250 like this. Dear learners, that was all today's discussion on syllabus in introductory class. Dear learners, you must collect your EFT, that is English for today, from market, and you also collect other books that is mentioned in your prospectus given you by the college authority. Dear learners, that is all today. Thank you very much.